Yeah, this is my Himalayan Sleet, guys. My red companion. And it's been totally loaded. A pannier has helped me a lot in packing my luggage. This pannier contains only camera gaze, it contains telescopic lens, it contains extender, it contains Canon 1DX camera, telescopic lenses 400mm f/5.6 lens Canon, and it contains a tinted visor. Presently I'm wearing a clear visor, so once the sun comes out totally, then I'll change it to the tinted visor. This one contains all my regular stuff, my clothes and my some medicines and chappals, such kind of stuff. Each pannier weighs around 10 kg, including the pannier weight. And this is my tripod, which I have mounted on the carrier. And this is my tank bag, which contains spare batteries, which contains battery charger, which contains mobile charger, some such kind of stuff which I require while riding, which I need to open and which I need to use it while riding. And RAM mount with my mobile and a mobile charger. Yeah, everything has been set. It's around 5:30. It became around half an hour late. It's okay. Usually I'll make it more than half an hour late, but this time it's only half an hour. I'm very happy with that. I'm keeping up on time. Yeah, let's move, guys, let's move. Himalayan has got a cold start problem, guys. Morning time, even if it gets started with one crank, it keeps on switching off. So we have to use the choke. And these Royal Enfield people knew about it, and I don't think that problem can be rectified. So that's why they're given the choke, in spite of this being a fuel injection bike. Amazing, Royal Enfield, amazing. This is the first ride on Himalayan Sleet, guys. First ride, a solo ride. And to do solo rides only, I bought this Himalayan Sleet. Basically, to do any touring, to do all kinds of touring, solo or with group, I bought this Himalayan Sleet. Earlier, I was doing with RC390, and it was pain doing touring on RC390. Somehow, I adjusted it, but further I couldn't adjust, so I thought, why not buy adventure tourer? And that video is there. The card for that video is somewhere on the right hand corner top. I'll be taking this route. I'll go via Tumkur, Chitradurga, Davangere, Haveri. From Haveri I have got two options, guys. One is to go over Kalgatti and then join Haliyal. Other one is to head straight, go to Upli, bypass Upli, and just before Dawad, there is one more deviation there. You have to take right and enter this Haliyal road. I don't know about this Kalgatti road, it's been ages I have taken this road. Whenever I used to go to Ganeshgudi, I used to go via Upli and Dawad only. So I don't know, I'll decide near Haveri which route I have to take. I'll just inquire about the road condition with the locals over there. If the road condition is really good, this Kalgatti road, and probably this time I might take this Kalgatti road. Yeah, guys, just done around 100 kilometers from Bangalore, crossed Tumkur, almost near Shira. There was a beautiful sunrise happening, so I thought I'll stop for some time, have a look at the sunrise. And even the median has been neatly decorated with flowering trees and all. So the stretch of the road looks really nice. Yeah, so far so good. Yeah, from past 20 minutes I was hunting for some hotel for my breakfast, and my prerequisites for a hotel was that I should be able to see my bike when I am eating my breakfast. So this one appears to be quite okay. I can sit there and I can have a view at my motorbike, because luggage is there on motorbike. Guys, somewhere after Iriyur, the highway is really smooth, not much of traffic, the bike is performing really well. Only thing is, what I have done is, I have loaded each pannier with around 5 kilos, so approximately, including the weight of the pannier per se itself, it will weigh around 8 kgs, so both the sides 8 kgs, and my tripod is around 2-2.5 kgs, that is mounted on the carrier. So with this amount of weight on the side of my on both the sides of my bike, I can feel that heaviness in the rear end. And I don't know, if I go beyond 100 or 110, the vehicle slightly sways, especially the front part, the front wheel. I don't know what is the problem with that, but what instructions they had given in the panniers, are, it should not be loaded more than 5 kilos. Anyway, I have loaded around 5 kilos only, not more than 5 kilos. Because of the panniers, I think the aerodynamic has changed a bit. And because of that, I am not able to go beyond 100 or 110 per kilometers per hour. That's what I guess. Because of that, the vehicle is slightly swaying. I don't know. Probably that might be the reason. So it's around 8:45 a.m. Covered around 200 kilometers. Left it around 5:30, 5:45. So in 3 hours, I covered around 200 kilometers. Yeah, that's pretty okay. Just no filled petrol. It has given around 100 kilometers for 3.3 or 3.4 liters, my Himalayan Sleet. And the remaining distance is around 282 kilometers, so roughly around 5 hours. Yeah, so far so good. Look at those windmills, guys. Changed my clear visor to tinted visor. The one good thing about traveling on a motorcycle is you don't have to pay toll. See, I've traveled this road n number of times. You know how much toll I'll pay for one way? I'll pay around 500 bucks. So it'll be 1000 rupees up and down only for toll. And that is not there when you're traveling in bike. Not much of wind today, I guess. None of the windmills are rotating. They're standstill. Yeah, the wind blush is also slightly less. Morning it was too much, but now it has come down a lot. So cruising around 100 kilometers per hour all day long is really a sweet spot. Is really a sweet spot for Himalayan Sleet. And I don't know why I keep telling Himalayan Sleet. Why can't I just tell Himalayan? Because both are same, engine-wise, everything. Only the style differs. Only the color paint differs. yeah, from next time onwards I'll just tell us Himalayan guys, no sleet. Oh, every time I do this fucking thing I'll always forget to put the strap of my helmet. Why I do this, I don't understand. Yeah, now we can have a look at these windmills much closer. Almost near Arihara guys. Look at these green fields, wow. As soon as I entered this stretch, I was getting that cool breeze. It's around 11:30 guys. Just took a detour from the main highway, Bangalore Hubli highway. This is the first time I am going through this route. Usually I used to go to Ganeshgudi through that route only. I used to go to Darwad. From Darwad I used to take a detour, go to Haldiyal, and from Haldiyal I used to go to Ganeshgudi. After inquiring with some locals, they said this is a bit closer, and the road has been entirely relaid with the new tarmac. And Google Maps is showing only 93 kilometers from this point, from this highway. So it's pretty much closer, around 30-40 kilometers closer than the usual road. Yeah, let's see. Wow, relatively traffic free, good tarmac. The speed decreases now. I used to maintain at around 100 kilometers per hour in that main highway. With this village road, probably I think it might come down to 60 or 70. I have to be careful because my both the panniers are fully loaded. I can't lean the vehicle much. At the same time, there is lot of gravel in the curve. Showing around 2 hours to cover this 91 kilometers. Yeah, at around 60 speed. Yeah, it might take 2 hours, probably 2.5 hours I think. So at 2 o'clock I might reach Ganeshgudi. Yeah guys, this is Kalagatti Haliyal road, goes through forest. ಎಚ್ಚರಿಕೆ, ತಿರುವುಗಳಿವೆ, ನಿಧಾನವಾಗಿ ಚಲಿಸಿ. ಯಾ ಗಾಟ್ ಇಟ್. ಆಫ್ ರೋಡಿಂಗ್ ಗಾಯ್ಸ್, ಆಫ್ ರೋಡಿಂಗ್, ಆಫ್ ರೋಡಿಂಗ್, ಆಫ್ ರೋಡಿಂಗ್, ಆಫ್ ರೋಡಿಂಗ್. That stretch of the road is getting laid with cement. This is entire forest guys. The road passes through the forest. Yeah, look at the condition of the forest in the summer. Almost all the trees are totally bald. Looks brown in color. Lifeless. Probably after 2 months, when the rain starts, when the monsoon begins, the entire area will be lush green. Entire area will be lush green. This is an amazing drive, around 20 kilometers inside the forest to Ganeshgudi. Amazing drive. Just now I left Haliyal after filling petrol over there. So from Haliyal, Ganeshgudi is around 34 kilometers. Out of that, around 20-25 kilometers is through forest only. It's a good drive. People have sighted Black Panther while passing on this road. Usually they keep crossing the road to go from one side of the forest to other side of the forest. If we are lucky enough, then we can also sight. Just reached Ganeshgudi, guys. So inside, once I go inside the JLR property, I won't get signal. So I had to call my dad. So just stopped near a shop, had one cool drinks and called him. Now I'm entering inside. Now I'm going inside JLR. Oh, what is that? German Shepherd. Yeah, from here the property starts. ಸುಮ್ಮನೆ ಹಿಂಗೆ ಬೈಕ್ ಟ್ರಿಪ್ ಬಂದ. ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ. ಹಾ, ವೆಹಿಕಲ್ ಬಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟ. ಹುಷಾರು ಹುಷಾರು. ಹಾ, ವಾಟ್ಸಪ್ಪಲ್ಲಿ, ಫೇಸ್ಬುಕ್ಕಲ್ಲ ಒಬ್ಬನೇ ಕಣ. ಹ್ಞೂ, ಅವ್ನು ಬಂದಿಲ್ಲ, ಅವ್ನು ಬರ್ತೀನಿ ಅಂದಿದ್ದ, ಅವ್ನು ಕೈ ಕೊಟ್ಬಿಟ್ಟ, ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಬೈಕಲ್ಲಿ ಬಂದಿದ್ದು, ಇಲ್ಲಾಂದ್ರೆ ಗಾಡೀಲಿ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೆ.